Hey, EFCA West. So remember a few weeks ago, I showed you a picture of my car being towed away because of complete system failure. You probably aren't interested in this at all, but I found it interesting that what ended up being the problem with my car was they said that rodents, yeah, like rats or a bunny or a possum or a cat, chewed through the wiring in my car, like crawled up into my engine and chewed through the harness and the wiring. I never had that happen before, but here's the crazy part. It happened twice. Like, we got the car back, and then a week later, the same thing happened again. Now, I didn't know this, but apparently, the casing around the wiring, the EPA mandated a law that said that because when rodents would chew through the wiring, they would die. And the people at the EPA felt bad about the rats and the possums and the bunnies and the cats dying. So they mandated that the casing around the wiring had to be made of soy so that the animals wouldn't die when they ate your car. So I said to the guy, I go, so basically my engine is like edible. And he goes, yeah. So put that next to all the things in life that you wonder, like, why is it like that? So I just got my car back yesterday from being gone for 2 weeks. That wasn't very fast, that whole process. It was very slow. But let me tell you something that is very fast, and that is the expedited license. Have you heard about this? In fact, it's so fast that we already have our very first inaugural EFCA Ministry License expedited recipient. Yes, his name's Ryan Lowe from Sunland Neighborhood Church in beautiful Sunland, California. Can you now listen? I was surprised because I thought, well, when they say expedited, I mean, in denominational terms, that probably means like 2025, right? And I say that and I work for a denomination. I mean, like when I think fast, think of like Ferraris or like fighter jets or, you know, me back in high school. So they're not kidding. Like from the minute we told you about the expedited license, there's already somebody who has one. So how about that? That's like super fast. So the point is, you should be encouraged if you're like, is it really expedited? It is expedited. So get on it, get your ministry license, and I think it's helpful for a lot of reasons of which we talked about. In fact, we have a whole podcast about it. You can go on our podcast page. And speaking of podcasts, our latest one's with Matt Larson. I guarantee you have something to learn from Matt Larson, because I had something to learn from Matt Larson. He is the lead and founding pastor of Anthem Church in Thousand Oaks, and he has launched the Anthem family of churches. And this guy just knows how to multiply. He knows how to multiply leaders. He knows how to multiply churches. He knows how to just multiply in general. I think he's got like 4 kids. So, I mean, there's a lot to learn from Matt Larson. So you can go on the EFCA podcast page and listen to that, because it's a really very well done interview, if I do say so myself. Finally, I had the opportunity last weekend, and many of you know I'm an Air Force chaplain in the reserves, right? So I had the opportunity last weekend to teach a marriage retreat, to be the main presenter at a marriage retreat here in Phoenix at a beautiful resort for 30 Air Force couples. And what was so significant about that to me, because we talked about communication, we talked about conflict, we talked about sex, we talked about all this kind of stuff. But the thing that really got them was when we kind of pulled everything together at the end and we talked about forgiveness. Now, I had to be careful because it was the chaplain corps, but I couldn't really do a whole lot of preaching. But here's the amazing thing, is when we talked about forgiveness, that was the part where the room went dead silent. And literally people all over the room were crying because they were talking about how hard it was to forgive the people that had hurt them in their life, not only their spouse, but other people. And while I couldn't get up there and preach, what I could do is what I did and say, hey, I'm not going to preach at you, but you have to figure out a mechanism for forgiveness wherever you are. I said, and I could say, as for me, and I did say, as for me, I believe in a God of justice and a God of mercy. And I was able to have so many sidebar conversations where I was able to share the gospel. It was like a fantastic weekend. But here's the thing that I was renewed in my mind about. And I've said this before, but the gospel message that you and I carry is really the only hope for the world. And that's why we have to be so careful when our congregations are getting all spun up about politics or even COVID and all this fear and all this anger, and we're getting off the message of the gospel. And I'm here to tell you that the message of the gospel is the message that transforms and changes lives. Because until people understand how they themselves can be forgiven and how to forgive the other people in their lives, they will always be stuck. They will always be bitter. They will always be incapable of truly loving someone else the way that they need to be loved. And their marriages will fail. Their families will fail, their generations will fail. And so why am I saying all this to you? Because you hold the key. You as a pastor, you as a church leader, the work you do is the most important work on the planet. I don't care what anybody says, because Jesus says, what good is it if you gain the whole world and lose your soul, right? What does it matter if you stay healthy your entire life, but then you die and go to hell? I'm just saying. So I say all this to you, and it's a little bit lengthy, but I wanted to encourage you, keep preaching in front of that camera, hang in there with that sparsely filled room, and don't stop preaching the gospel of forgiveness and hope and grace, because that is what every single person needs, and you got it, so deliver it. I'm so excited to be able to be standing with you as part of the Evangelical Free Church of America. Thank you for all you do.